सियावर रामचंद्र की, सियावर रामचंद्र की।
सब्सक्राइब टू आवर YouTube चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन टू गेट द लेटेस्ट अपडेट्स।
जय सियाराम। This is how Prime Minister Narendra Modi started his speech soon after the conclusion of the Bhoomi Pujan in Ayodhya today. Prime Minister Narendra Modi stressed on the fact that the construction of Ram Mandir in Ayodhya will act as an instrument to unite the country. The Prime Minister said August 5th should be treated as important as August 15, the Independence Day of India, emphasizing on the fact that so many people sacrificed their lives as part of the Ayodhya movement. This is a significant statement coming from the Prime Minister, as on one hand he's stressing on the need to move forward and how the temple will connect all. At the same time, he's emphasizing on the sacrifices of those who were part of the Ayodhya movement. The Prime Minister also emphasized Ram is everywhere, Ram belongs to all, and termed the upcoming Ram Janmabhoomi temple as a modern symbol of our culture, eternal faith and national spirit, and stressed on the need of Sabka Saath Sabka Vishwas. In his speech, PM Modi also stressed on the fact that the temple will boost the economy of the region and said this is why we are constructing a Ram circuit in Ram's own city. The Ram temple, he said, will help the economy of this region. This again is an important statement being made by the Prime Minister, as the millennials and the youth of Ayodhya and surrounding areas are hopeful that the construction of Ram Mandir will lead to job creation and overall development. The culmination of the Ayodhya movement in the Bhoomi Pujan is also significant for the ruling Bharatiya Janata Party, as the Saffron Party was closely associated with the Ram Janmabhoomi movement in the 1990s, and Prime Minister himself visited the site after a gap of 29 years. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath was also present on the dais along with Modi and termed it a huge moment for India, for which generations have waited for long. It is likely to take around 3 years, and some part of the structure will be ready by 2022 when the assembly elections will be held in Uttar Pradesh. With Bihar elections all set to take place in October this year, the party may reap electoral benefits from the move too. The Bhoomi Pujan has also made it crystal clear that the top leaders of the Bharatiya Janata Party, termed as the poster boys of the movement, including Lal Krishna Advani, Murali Manohar Joshi and VHP leader Praveen Togadia, will now no longer be able to come to the limelight again. The Bhoomi Pujan also seems to have demolished the opposition of opposition parties, as right from Congress leader Rahul Gandhi, General Secretary of Uttar Pradesh Congress Priyanka Gandhi Vadra and Samajwadi Party leader Akhilesh Yadav, apart from a number of other opposition leaders, have not only welcomed the move of constructing a Ram Mandir, but at the same time they have emphasized that we need to learn from the teachings of Lord Ram. With Suraj Singh Bish, this is Neelam Pandey reporting from Ayodhya for The Print.